everybody, so welcome to my channel. I am Mai-Kristin, for those of you who doesn't know me, I live in Norway, and this channel is my little creative corner, and today it's going to be about crochet and knitting and yarn, or other yarn related things. So I will be talking and showing what I have recently finished and what I'm working on now, and a little bit of what my plans are further on, and a little bit what I have gotten in or bought the last month or so. Yeah, I think that will be pretty, or is that? Is that all? Yeah. Yeah, like I said, crochet in anything. Well, I kind of have to say that if you want to know more about me, I have an episode where I introduce myself more. So if you are curious, you can jump over to that and have a look. Yeah. So let's just get started. Recording this again in my craft space, because my living room is taken. There are people there, so yeah, so I kind of have to do this here. First, what I have finished lately is first out is this dog blanket. I got a whole lot of those lucky bags. You can see the color is, yeah, probably more there. Lucky bags from Tarom Hobby, which contained a lot of acrylic yarn. I don't really use that much. Since I am in Norway, it is kind of wool, different kinds of wool and other fibers that are that we are working with here. The most, so acrylic usually goes for blankets and stuff. And so I got a whole bunch of this yarn. It's an bulky weight called We Love Yarn, there, from Hobby. And this color is color number 18. I think it was called Plum or something. Yeah. So that is just one big granny square. Crocheted with a 7mm crochet hook. So and my dogs really loves it. They enjoy it a lot. I was going to Oslo to get myself a spinning wheel, so I kind of needed something to work on while I was on the train, and I kind of didn't want to have something that I had to sit there and count and stuff. So I just grabbed a 7mm and some alpaca berries yarn from biking, and the rim color, what's it that? No, let me just check. I have this wonderful app called Knit Note, which I really love. No, Winter Glow from Hobby, in the color 02, which was cognac. So I had alpaca berries from Viking is color 35. So held those together, it made some kind of this olive green, but also with some orange, some blue brown spots, if I can hold it there. There you actually can see it better. Some yellow parts, some orange, blue, purples, more orange in it. So the way it looks, it kind of starts small in the one end, and then you go, it gets wider and wider and bigger, and then it gets smaller again or more narrow again. So it is a quite big scarf, kind of the shape of a Sophie scarf, but this is called the winter bin. So I started out with a kind of a pattern from Bobby called the winter wind scarf, and I just adjusted it and sew into my my yarn and my hook size, and and went off there. So this is a nice warm winter scarf we have there. I have to put it behind me. And then in September in Norway we have this charity called the Golden Ribbon, which is raising money and awareness against the children's cancer. So then the knitting and yarn society here in Norway come together, and a whole lot of people are doing what they can to raise money. So you can buy special dyed yarn, you can buy patterns, tickets for the blankets, and a lot of stuff. So I have also bought both yarn and stuff, but also a recipe for a winter hat, which is called Gullungen Lua. It's kind of the golden child hat, winter hat. It comes with 8 patterns, so you can choose which one you want to make, and I made the squirrels. Because I, when I got my spinning wheel, I also bought some white wool, so I could spin up to my own yarn, and I had already bought this brown fiber, which is merino, tencel, and bamboo, so to practice my spinning on. So I did. I made up all of that wool and so I spun all of that up, but I didn't want to have it just lying around doing nothing with it. So I wanted to use it. After all, I had spun it, so why not use it? I'm not really a big fan of just having things for keepsake, as a keepsake, and not use it. So on the internet they said that you can't knit with a single spun thread. You can only use it to weave or to crochet. So I wanted to kind of test out and see how it looked like, then why can't I knit with a single. So I knitted up this hat in singles, and I think it worked quite well. You can of course see that this is hand spun, and that I am brand new at it, because I have some thinner parts and some chunkier parts. But I kind of like that. I think that is a part of the charm. Now if I did want some yarn that looked full fabric spun, I just might have bought myself. But when I actually do something and put a lot of time in it to subbing this up myself. I kind of want it to look like I have made it also. So I really, really like the texture of it, and that you can see is something some thick. Of course, some of it is overspun and some maybe underspun, but that is kind of where I was when I made this, so I think it's okay. And to go with this hat, I crocheted a couple of mittens as well. So this is the one of them, the same yarn, everything. So this is crocheted on a 5mm crochet hook. I think it worked very well to crochet singles as well. So I don't really understand why you can't knit singles or just weave them on. So many people are making a whole bunch of rules for things. But I think that it kind of worked very well. Now of course this is itchy because it is palain wool from the sheep's fall cut. You see? Yeah, I think it looks so. It might be quite itchy, but if it's too bad, I just have to put something on the inside, or I will work it out. And it's not like I don't have enough hats as it is. So, yeah. But now I have something made from the wool that I spun up my very, very first yarn that I spun myself. So I am quite proud of it. So yeah, a couple of mittens and a gullungen lue, this hat. One knit, one crochet. So to test that out. Yeah. And I think it worked quite well. So my son wanted some potholders, so I said that of course I can make you a pair of those because I have a lot of the cotton yarn in my stash. So I just dived in and found some yarn for him. Now he loves blue, so I just found one light blue skein or a ball and a darker blue ball, held those together and crocheted these two. Then I just found a gare that I held double and made the edging for that. So since this is stash yarn, I don't know what it is other than it is cotton, 100% cotton, I know that, but yeah, so I can't really say anything else about this yarn. While I was at it, I took some inspiration from the book called Did His Book Will Teach You How to Crochet by Zoe Bateman. And in that book she also had this pattern that she called Krokonk. Yeah, I don't know the English word for that, but this stitch pattern was there, and I think that was quite neat and I wanted to test it out. So I just made a couple of pot holders for ourselves as well. Now this yarn, I know what is, this is Mandarin Naturel, which is 100% cotton as well. This is yarn color 7024. You can see from the tag that it's quite old yarn. So, and when I found it, I didn't even know that I have Mandarin Naturel in my stash. I thought I only had Mandarin Petit. From Sandnes yarn. Yeah. So now we have a pair of new potholders as well, so not only our son. Then my daughter has, oh hang on, so I just had to get one of the dogs in. Yeah, so my daughter is having a birthday coming up now, so I wanted to knit her something, so I knit her this sweater called Wilfreda. It's designed by a woman called Wenche Roald. So yeah, this, you can see it starts up there, and this has this beautiful pattern there. Now the color is kind of washed out some, doesn't really come out the way as it really is. Now I see that my face also turns quite pink, so yeah, it looks quite dark getting there, but it is quite lighter. Anyway, it is knitted with the dream color from Hobby, and to in the color for something, let me see. There we have, I'm using this beautiful app called Knit Note. I just love it. So maybe this, take that away, maybe that will show, no, that doesn't really show the color either. Anyway, it is Mystery Forest, color number 81, together with a kid silk from Viking, number 332, which also is a green color. So yeah, it has it's further up in the back than in the front, and it also is further down at the back on the at the back than it is in the front. So I think that it's fitting very, very well. So I just hope that she will like it. So yeah, when I knitted this up, I also had some leftover yarns, so I knitted as well a hat for this sweater. Now this pattern is from Marte Helgetun, from a or it's in this pump. Palette called Fairy Hats. So this is one of those patterns in that. So in, of course, in the same yarn, because this is then the leftover yarns from this set. Now this hat is quite big, so I think that I should, or maybe put it in my washing machine and see if I can felt it a little bit and shrink it some. So I do hope that she will like this as a gift, or yeah. And if she doesn't, I don't mind bearing it. So I can get her something else. No, I'm just kidding. I'm sure that she will love it. She usually likes everything that I make for her. So that was it. So I made her a Wilfreda, and I really want one myself. So I'm kind of working on it. I haven't started knitting on it, but I have spun quite a lot of yarn for it. I have bought some Angora yarn and some Corydale, holding those two together, or making one again Angora, and then I make one of or with the Corydale, and then I twist those two together, and are making yarn looking like this. So I should open this up so I can show you closer up. how it looks like that. So it is just dirty with a little bit of purple spots in it, because I really really love purple, and the Angora that I bought had some purple merino wool in it as well. So now I really love the Angora fiber, but making a full sweater of only Angora is not recommendable. So you need something with that is a little bit stronger, that can kind of hold it a little bit better. So they recommend that you use something else to hold it, like a cordial. So that is what I'm doing. So I have been spinning. So this is to the ends that is twisted together. I have one big one there, and this is awesome. Yeah, anyways, here. So I have now 667 meters of yarn. I have a little bit more spun up, so I just have to twist it. And then I actually think that I might have enough yarn for making myself a Wilfreda. And of course this have taken me quite some time. I'm sorry for the crinkling that I can't have to move stuff. Yeah. So this have taken up quite a lot of my time. So, but I really really love it. I love to spin. It's something about this repetitive spinning motion, I guess. It just yeah, it feels really really good. So that is what I have been working on. I'm also of course working on a pair of socks. I have this woven check socks, designed by Steven West. They look like that. So that is the leg and the cuff and the leg, and this is kind of the foot going. Yeah, this is the heel. So I have gotten as far as I'm supposed to be on this one before I'm starting on the toe, when I noticed that I actually had to rip back 5 lines, so I have made them way too long. So yeah, so this is one, I've gotten that far, and this is number 2. So I have starting to turning the heel on this one, so I'm not doing them at the same time, but I'm doing them at the same time. Kinda, yeah. The yarn I'm using for this is from the ropes. So I'm using one ball of this fable long print in this color, changing colors, and then I use one called unicolor, holding those two together. So this baron is color number 300. This long print is color number 651. Yeah, those socks are for my husband, hopefully. Yeah, so I'm working on that, and I am also knitting on this square blanket, but since I'm going to make like 100 squares, I'm not going to show those every time at all. Yeah. Working on something else. Yeah, my son really wanted this sweater. It's called a Viking sweater. Here you can see how the sweater is going to be, like that. There you can see that nice young man. So it is a braided sweater. So I'm quite new in knitting, so and making braids is not something that I have done a lot. I have made one pair of socks with that. So I thought that I would start on the arms. Now this is a pattern where you make different parts, like you make two arms, front panel, back panel, sewing everything together. So I have started on the arm. So I have one arm done. This is one arm. Now you can see the color quite okay, I guess. There you can see it. Now the braids are of course in there. This will show better when it's locked and all. Now it's not, it's just knitted and then put into my bag. So I have one arm done and I have started on a second one there. So, but look at that color. My son loves this color. So it was quite hard finding exact that color, so it took me some time. But then there was a sale on this big warehouse called Spurship, so I went there, and luckily I did find this this yarn called Rubin Superwash from Gjesdal. This one, on sale, so of course I got that. That is what I'm working with, working with on this sweater for him. That is kind of what I am working on, now. Then I asked my daughter-in-law what she wanted for Christmas, because I have started learning that knitting and crocheting and things take time. So, and we are quite many in our family, so I have started working or thinking about Christmas gifts, like this sweater for my son. It's supposed to be a Christmas gift. Anyway, my daughter-in-law wanted something made by me, and she wanted something in emerald green. So I've been kind of on a search for that. Haven't really found the exact color that I had in mind. For those of you who know the emerald green in pastel polychromos pencil, that is kind of the color that I wanted to have for her, and I think that she actually wanted, but haven't really found that. But I was in a yarn store in the town next by, and had a look, and I did find some yarn. If I'm holding this up here, so hopefully this is as close to what she wanted as I possibly can come. So I bought up got two skeins of Camilla Peel's Fnugg, and I bought four false skeins, whatever it's called, Laura from the ropes. Now this is a wool and alpaca mix, so it is really really soft and nice and not itchy at all. So held those two together, it's going to be really nice. And I hope that I have enough for making like I know that I have enough for a hat and some mittens, and maybe even a neck or something, like a cowl or yeah, anything, something. Hopefully, let's see how far I'm getting with what I have for now. I also bought a new set of knitting needles. Not a new set, but a new knitting needle. So this is Chagu, 4.5 millimeters, 14 centimeters. So perfect for like a hat, because I didn't have 4.5 millimeters in Chagu. So I wanted to have that. I've also been visiting Sweden. Now I live very close by Sweden, so we went to a town called Stubbemsta, because there was supposed to be this really nice yarn store called Skattkistan, which means the treasure chest. So we went there and I visited. I did not buy any yarn there. Now she did have lots of wonderful hand-dyed, beautiful yarn, but nothing what I really was looking for or what I liked. For my Angora, I will also support Norwegian sports more than Swedish, really. Anyways, I did get something there. I bought this bag. Now, isn't this the cutest thing ever? I think it was just so beautiful. It's a grey tote bag. Quite simple tote bag, but it has sheep on it. And it has a short handle, and it also has some longer ones. So, I think this was just so cute. Now this store and this town is also hosting like a festival later on in September. So this knitting pattern comes from this place called Bohusdikning. So they will have this festival there. Yeah, but that is. Well, if you want to come, just let me know in the comments and I will give you the link for it. Anyways, I did not buy yarn on that store, but there is a bookstore that I really love. It usually has a lot of things, and I always pop by there when I am in this town. So we did that this time as well, and they have yarn there as well. Now Sweden and Norway, and I guess that Denmark as well, and sells yarn pretty much everywhere. You can buy it at the grocery store, but also other stores. So this bookstore also sold yarn. So I got this skein of mellanragi, which is a sock yarn. Again, in this green color that I was looking for my daughter-in-law. So kind of, yeah, that color. So I had to pick that up. Now this is a Jarbo garn, which is a Swedish company. You can see the Swedish flag on the side there. Yeah, so Jarbo is Swedish, so this is mellanragi, so this is a sock yarn. So I got that. They also have some fluffy manos. This bookstore also carried Chagu knitting needles. So of course I had to get one just to get that one. And so this is the 4 millimeter, 40 centimeters. So so I just got 4 and 4.5. So now I have that at least. But they had this beautiful tencel ugly sock yarn. I've never seen sock yarn with tencel, but it really feels quite cool and soft. So I think it's for socks, if it actually gives this kind of cool chilly effect a little bit, yeah, I think that will be perfect for socks. I have no idea how tencel works for socks and never used it for socks, so I thought why not test that out, and I really love these colors. So I've got two of this turquoise blue colors. Now they look quite more blue on my camera and what they looks for me in real life, but I can't quite change that. I picked up one, oh my god, no, I'm losing my things. I picked up one Garay, again, tencel raggi. That is color number 2501. This turquoise is 2505. Those, and then I got one brown. Brown color number 2508, and one pink. Look at this pink, it's beautiful, I love it. So that is number 2507. So this is the colors that I got. Quite a lot of socks in this, yeah, with this. Now you don't have to make socks with sock yarn, but it is quite good for it. So this contains by it was 75% wool and 25% tencel. So it is wool as well, so they are warm, yeah, and soft and nice. Really nice. Now where should I put them while I get up those two last hanks? They also had, this is something I never tested out before either. This is called, it was Yarbo Perfect number three, but it is impossible to see. this is alpaca, baby alpaca and silk. Can't really see how much of each. Yeah, there I can. 70% baby alpaca and 20% mulberry silk, and actually 10% yak. So yeah, so I got those two, one pink, and again in that beautiful dusty kind of pink color, and this turquoise, beautiful color. So I can hold those together, or I can make something with each one of them. 150 gram hank is 188 meters, so it's quite thin, but yeah, it will last a long time and anyway. So and I think it's beautiful, it feels so amazing. I did not getting more because these were on sale as well, and they are wonderful, beautiful. So that was it. What I have made, what I'm working on, and some of my plans in the future. So both hat and mittens for my daughter-in-law, and this will Wilfreda for me. Yeah, I think that was everything. So if you have any question or comments, just let me know in the comment section underneath this video. I usually respond to everything. So just ask and I will do my best to answer as well as I can. Until next time, stay safe, take care, and I love you all. Bye!